add up, the pressure to maintain momentum becomes a major factor.
Every fighter who competes in the octagon will tell you that he will take a win by any means possible. But as one of the UFC's top strikers, this flyweight star is taking the judges out of the equation, as he has used fists and feet to finish each of his opponents during his winning streak by way of spectacular knockout.
That's it for today. Stay tuned for your next UFC Minute, and I'll see you at the fights.
All right, coming up next, it's a UFC flyweight division matchup. All right, so here he is. Really, for my money, as accomplished a submission specialist and Brazilian jiu-jitsu practitioner as has crossed into the UFC in years. We'll see how quickly tonight he can get this fight to the ground and utilize his high-level submission skills. Outstanding choke game. A lot of different chokes in his repertoire. We'll see if he can get them going tonight.
This guy is a world-class Brazilian jiu-jitsu artist. His submissions are incredibly technical, and he chains them one after the other. You defend one, he attacks with another.
Took a drill, now we take a sprint. I wasn't made the job, I'm on ships.
Well, this is an outstanding kickboxer making his way to the UFC Octagon right now. Very interesting stylistic matchup here tonight. Just an outstanding arsenal of kicks, great punching technique, power in both hands, works the lead leg, not afraid to work the body. Just a complete kickboxer here, now plying his trade in mixed martial arts. A dangerous proposition for anyone caught in his striking range.
This fighter has an iron jaw. I have seen him take shots on the chin and not be affected, shots that would knock a lesser man completely unconscious.
And now our tale of the tape for this flyweight tilt. So 3 years the gap in age between these two fighters, with similar height and some differences in reach. All right, now for the official introductions, we send it inside the octagon to Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, this fight is three rounds in the UFC flyweight division. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner. This man is a jiu-jitsu fighter, holding a professional record of 5 wins, 2 losses. He stands 5 feet, 5 inches tall, weighing in at 125 pounds. Fighting out of the tall Brazil, Bulletproof. And now introducing his opponent, fighting out of the red corner. This man is a kickboxer, holding a professional record of 7 wins, 1 loss. He stands 5 feet, 7 inches tall, weighing in at 125 pounds. Fighting out of Las Vegas, Nevada, USA, Assassin. And when the action begins, our referee in charge, Eve Levine.
The veteran Eve Levine draws the assignment here.
Ready? You ready?
Here we go. All right, ready to go for round one, and this young man's popularity absolutely soared on the strength of what he did his last time out. It was a win by flush knockout, kept his winning streak intact with style points, and now the challenges get decidedly more tougher. We'll see if he can keep the momentum going in what is unquestionably the biggest spot of his UFC career. Now mixing one into the body.
Nice punch.
All right, so here we go with round one. There is no denying just how much power this fighter has in his kick. So let's see how early he chooses to attack with it. Does he go low to the leg? Does he go high to the head? Let's see how the early portions of this fight play out. Oh, and there is that patented head kick. Landing a good series of strikes here.
And from here, transitions to the Muay Thai clinch.
That knee might have landed there.
Oh, nice
big knee! Oh! He's got him hurt here. A beautiful kick to the body there, and he just left himself wide open for that strike. Very vulnerable by leaning in, keeping the guard high to allow for an opening down low. Strong work with the inside leg kick. Well-placed kick there, Joe.
Big punches.
Well, he just missed on another strike there. He has not been efficient with his attack here tonight. And offensively, I think his approach leaving a lot to be desired. Gotta figure out a way to conserve some energy here moving forward.
Front kick to the face. Good punch.
Once again, establishing the jab here.
Very good job of timing these punches.
Trying to establish that jab once again.
Nice leg kick. He's got good accuracy on that jab. Powerful leg kick.
We got a fight, folks. Inside leg kick is good.
Kick, look at that.
30 seconds now to go in round one.
High kick! Piero! This could be it right here.
Oh!
Oh, he's knocked down!
Oh!
What a leg kick! Very nice.
Oh! Horn sound for the end of round one.
Let's take a look at it again here. And here another big shot lands and another knockdown. And here another clean shot lands and another knockdown. What an action-packed round. It looked like it almost ended on multiple occasions.
Brittany Palmer is here as always.
A huge roundhouse kick for the knockout.
Yeah, Joe, as far as highlights go, they don't get much prettier than that. A huge kick to end the night here tonight. He caught his opponent flush, full force, full extension, and that one was a no-doubter. The fight was over as soon as that foot made contact.
Let's take a look at that again. Watch this again here. I mean, just stiff.
Well, what a moment for this fighter here tonight. A massive knockout on the sport's biggest stage. Seminal moment for that fighter tonight. We send it inside the octagon to Bruce Buffer for the official decision.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Eve Levine is going to stop for this contest at 3 seconds of round number two. Declaring the winner by knockout, Assassin.
So there's the man of the moment, just the way he drew it up here tonight as he gets his hand raised and does so emphatically by way of the KO. Perhaps some bonus money is coming his way at the end of the night. I'm not sure. Still a few fights to go, but at the very least, you can be sure. His next fight will be a big one, and he will celebrate deep into the night with his teammates, his coaches, and his friends after this monumental victory here under the bright lights tonight.